As part of the ISFSI project on understanding and fighting basement fires, we're examining a number of different nozzles to give firefighters options. Some basements have no exterior windows or any access through an exterior door, so their only access is through an interior stair. So we're examining the fire dynamics of that type of fire, and then looking at options of making a hole just inside the door threshold and perhaps using a straight stream nozzle or a fog nozzle or perhaps a piercing nozzle, a fog nail, or some sort of cellar nozzle in order to cool it off, prevent any type of chance of flashover prior to making entry and going down into the basement. So we're doing some flow testing of the nozzles just to look at their pattern, look at their flow rates, things like the fog nail, very small device. It flows on the order of 15 to 17 gallons per minute, produces a pretty fine spray of water droplets near the ceiling. The piercing nozzles also do a similar thing. They flow on the order of 125 gallons a minute. Some of the piercing nozzle designs where you'd pound it down through the floor give you a fairly fine spray or mist that extends out 8 to 10 feet and would, again, cool the wood underneath, cool the gases. People use them for attic fires as well. And then other piercing nozzles have more of a discharge out and down, and they can flow up to 200 gallons a minute. And as you increase the pressure and the flow rate, the water droplets get smaller. In those cases as well. Again, the idea is to get the water on the surface of the burning ceiling of the basement, the unprotected wood ceiling of the basement. That's really the bulk of the fuel, and that's one of the higher challenges of knocking out that basement fire. We sort of have two different types of cellar nozzles that we're working with. One is the Bresnan distributor, which is sort of the classic cellar nozzle, and it has solid streams that emit from it and rotate around, again throwing water up and against the ceiling area to cool the wood and the floor assembly that's on fire. And then we have another version that's also a rotating applicator type nozzle, except it has four fog nozzles on it that whip around and have a fog spray that's, again, cooling the ceiling, cooling the gases, trying to distribute water through the basement with a throw of at least 10 feet, maybe 12 feet in some cases. When you use a straight stream, or a solid stream nozzle, and you shoot it down through, say, a hole in the floor, it basically just penetrates the hot gas layer and most of the water ends up on the floor. So these are very inefficient and ineffective for that kind of use. These particular tests are not focused on structural collapse. We've designed them to try to keep that out of place so we can look at the suppression and the flow path. However, if you're interested in the structural collapse research that UL FSRI has done, please go to our webpage, ulfirefightersafety.org, and we've got two courses there on structural collapse, actually three, including the Governor's Island, that include some components of structural collapse, so you can get an understanding of the timing, how rapidly it happens, or how rapidly it can happen, and why it's such a high risk, and why we're looking for other options for attacking and fighting basement fires.